Fuck right, us. No,
I'll call her. Hold on. I'll see if she wants to play.
Hey, what you up to, guys?
Red King.
Fuck you and the fucking whore mother you crawled out of. I hope your fucking wife's uterus falls out and your dick falls off at the same time.
Ooh, that's very nice. Continue.
Flat fucking account, pussy. Now I would set aside my Christian ethics just to kick you in the fucking mouth, you motherfucker.
Brett, turn off your blog TV.
Brett, he's willing to go to hell for that. Why not?
Well, Kimberly and Sabella is as close to a real hell as we'll ever get.
Somebody needs to mute their blog TV. I'm getting echo.
Yeah, I'm getting bad echo.
It's probably his.
It's not the echo and that cavern you call a brain.
So you could start drama between their friends and make up these fake sock accounts and make all these bulls. You get your fucking kicks off of it. You don't give a fuck if you got a partnership or what. All you're on YouTube is having fucking fun playing the game. Playing people out, ruining their fucking account, man. Fuck you straight to hell, motherfucker, with a baseball bat with Nathan.
Mr. Wolf, you wouldn't happen to have any evidence for any of these accusations, would you?
Shit. Fuck you. I don't care what the fuck you have to say. Don't even speak to me, fucking piece of shit.
Well, I'm just asking, do you got any evidence for any of these claims?
I don't care what the fuck you have to ask.
So you're not going to provide any evidence? You just going to talk trash?
Shit to me. That's all you are. Something to be scooped up and fucking thrown in the trash. Just like your mama should have done with a coat hanger.
Are you going to be screaming now? Because I love it when you do that. Yell for me, please.
Can I respond?
Yell at me. Come on, give it to me, baby. Come on, sir.
You ass. Oh, motherfucker.
My name is Raven Wolf, and I'll take no shit off of you, boy.
I love it. Give it to me. So what about you, Wooly? How you doing?
I'm doing okay. I'm doing fine.
Yeah, me and Sister Sunshine are friends. I actually did an interview with her. I can provide you a video over on the side if you'd like to see.
I would not be your friend. I told her straight up, I said, Brett is not being your friend. He's being a douchebag to you. I don't know what you've done with her in the past. Oh, you know what? That's right, she dropped the Christianity.
Yeah, I actually got blamed for that shit, but that's not true.
So someone blamed you for that?
Yeah, people said that she would talk to me so much on Stickam and on the phone and everything, because we do
she
talk...
She dropped the Christianity long after all that Stickam stuff ended.
Well, I know that, but people still blamed me for that. Of course I'm not to be at fault for something like that, jeez.
But you know what? I'm sure it all evens out. You probably did some bad shit you didn't get in trouble for, so it's okay.
I haven't done anything wrong whatsoever. I think Sister Sunshine is a wonderful person. I hope she continues to rock and roll in videos.
Oh, boy. You do realize you blocked me just because I said I wouldn't join your Facebook.
Blocked me over to Facebook?
Yeah, I said I have privacy concerns, so I'm sorry. I can't join your Facebook thingy, and then you blocked me.
Shit, I don't remember any of that.
I know.
I guess the damn people are my Facebook. I can't recall names over Facebook, really?
Yeah.
I just recently made a video said I think Facebook sucks.
Because nobody's going to join your Facebook. Of course.
Well, I got like 500.
My Facebook is awesome.
Accounts and then another or any other, so what's your point? Lily, why are you so... Are you serious? Are you pissed off at me over some kind of Facebook blocking
thing? No. I don't have the same sort of history other people have with you. And when all that big drama for you happens, with the plagiarism and all that stuff, I mean, I had just started paying attention to YouTube, and I looked and saw some of the stuff they were saying, but, you know, I was interacting with you on Instagram, so it was all kind of mediated. But then, you know, I saw more and more stuff, and personally, you haven't really done anything to me, but I didn't see what you did in Stigmadeign, which wasn't cool. My girlfriend hates your guts.
Over in Stigmadeign? I'm not exactly sure what you're talking about. I've been in Stigmadeign a million fucking times. What are you talking about?
Yeah, I know. You were doing, you were having these regular sessions with Sister Sunshine, and you just kind of run her through the ringer. She obviously wasn't capable of answering most of the questions, and she wasn't feeling so hot. And then you were basically being extremely rude to someone you would consider, you would call a friend if any of this stuff would start. You know,
well,
we
I guarantee if you were to ask Sister Sunshine in this room right now, she would tell you that I've been nothing but respectful and decent to her. She still talks to me through Facebook.
Oh, why did you get all clever when she said she wasn't talking to you anymore? And we all supported her. We're like, yeah, don't talk to that fuckface.
Yeah, I don't know where you're getting all that shit from. Me and her actually do talk, and we are friends, so I don't know where you're getting that from.
You don't remember when she said, I'm not talking to you, Brett Kane, anymore. Don't
no,
talk to me.
No, she has never said anything like that. In fact,
I
does not ever be silent. You don't ever let nobody speak. Goodness gracious. Me and her used to discuss the Bible back whenever she was a religious person. Back when she was into the whole Christianity and all that.
Yeah,
and we still talk from time to time. So what's your point?
Oh, my God.
Pull her
in
here.
Do you ever eat up the bullshit that comes out of your mouth, or do you have no taste buds at all, man?
Well, pull her in here. We'll see about that. Take you 2 minutes to prove me wrong. Just get a hold of her. Tell her to come in here and see what happens. And he goes silent. How about that? Next!
See if I can get her.
Sister Sunshine?
Yeah.
I've never spoken with her personally.
She's a really, really nice person.
Ah.
Very cool.
And you're full of shit, because she totally fucking told you to go take a hike and she wasn't talking to you ever again. You treat her like shit, dude. You even made a video about it. We fucked. To me, I don't know why you won't talk to me. What did I do?
Oh, this guy. Who is this fucking guy?
You
who
remember
is this? This
guy
is so bullshit. Bring her in here real quick. Go ahead and own your ass together. That's bullshit, man.
Oh, Sister Sunshine.
Is this guy trolling or what? Is he just having a good old time? I was having more fun listening to Raven Wolf. At least he's exciting. Come on.
Okay. Go ahead. Talk to Raven Wolf. You don't have to listen to me.
Well, while that's happening, could you still try to get Sister Sunshine? I'd like to talk to her.
Yeah, that'd be awesome.
So, Brett, Stiggy, he did accuse you of flagging his channel.
Well, he'd be wrong. I've also got flagged too. Have you seen my strike?
Yeah.
So...
My only interest on YouTube is to simply upload videos, be able to say my opinion just like everybody else and shit. There's a lot of assholes out there pulling shit, so, I mean, what can you do? I mean, I could sit here all day and say, no, it's not me, I'm not doing that, but people are going to believe whatever they want to believe, so why bother? You understand?
Oh my God, then why the fuck are you here? Just fucking go away.
Because I like talking to people. Especially if Sister Sunshine's coming on. And also, another thing too, Ravenous Wolf, if you and Sabella are still getting married, congratulations, and I hope the best for you on that.
You hope the best for him? You just said that...
Yeah.
You just said that...
Me and Wolf, man, we have this kind of... love-hate situation. We like to goof on each other every once in a while. He does news clippings and shit, obviously, and I sit here and be silly towards him about the box cutting incident. Nothing personal.
Okay. Gotcha. iCalintz, you need to add me on Skype. Not that hard to find. I'll pull you right the fuck in here too. Let's just continue this love soup.
Love soup.
And Godlessmanitoban, quit hiding and turn your fucking Skype on. I'll pull your fucking ass in here too.
Let me see if I can get a hold of Sister Sunshine TV.
You do it.
I'm going
to. You talk to her all the time. Go ahead, you do it.
Alright, let me see. Give her the BlogTV link. Hello, friend. Please. Come in here, show me, and chat, and give the link. Would you like to see a screenshot? Here we go. I'll screenshot it, make a thing with the paint program, show that this was done. Huh?
Oh, we've got Godlessmanitoban in the call.
All right. What's up, Mr. Mantoba, or whatever you pronounce your name?
Not a lot.
There we go.
Hello?
Okay.
Yeah, my computer over here, I'm swapping computers. Just the other computer.
Okay.
Mr. Manitoban, do you have any
There you go.
Do you have any charges to lay on any of the people here in Skype right now?
No, I don't really care about any of them, really. Stigmadeign, like, one time I made a point in his video, and then Ashley Dakota came along and, like, attacked me, like I was attacking him. I said, I'm not attacking Stigmadeign, I just said, like, there was a mistake in his video, and she did her whole, I'm a debater! She can be a debater all she wants, but I don't know. Like, if that's her purpose on the internet, well, I'm not into debating. I just point out shit and whatever.
Well, Ashley is not here right now. I could try to contact her, but she's not even online. Or she's, you know, hidden. So I can't get her.
Yeah, I know. It's unfortunate because, you know, I like being yelled at by people from Minnesota. I mean, South Dakota, well, you know.
Have you guys downloaded it?
Fuck. Drop my keyboard there.
Okay, so who left?
Lowly? Yeah, Lowly left for something, I don't know. Probably trying to get somebody to come into the call. Let's see.
I'm back. One too many white people for him. Gotta go.
You know who I could add, just to be funny, you know? Oh, I got a contact request. I'll just add him, whoever he is. He'll have to introduce himself. Oni Gummo. I have no idea who that is.
Me neither. Oh.
Probably Aldous Fowler. Or is it meant to be the retarded girlfriend?
Oh, that's
cold-blooded,
man.
All the phantom lion.
That's bigoted.
I'm going to go ahead and just on a whim, I'm going to add DM Crispin to this call.
Who's that?
Without even telling her what I'm not even going to broach the subject.
Yeah. Hey, Rick.
How you doing there, Oni? What's your story?
This is iCal, yeah?
Hi, iCalintz.
Hey, everybody. You. Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Just here to bring up the hate.
Do you have anyone in this call that you hate that you want to vent on?
Not really. I'm just here to, I guess, stir up shit, basically. But see, I hate Sting, Brett. I mean, I made a video making fun of Brett's penis disorder because it was funny. Let's see, and I don't know anybody else, but I'm sure I hate him too.
A penis disorder? When did I have that?
I don't know. I mean, it's not, you're not working down, right? So I just assume, you know.
No, why are you so interested in my penis for? You want me to teabag you or something?
That's pretty disgusting. But sure, why not?
I mean, you made a 10, what did you make, 5-10 minute video about another man's penis? That tells me.
You made a 5-10 minute video about Onision and drag because you seem to have a thing for him, so.
Okay. Touche.
I make video about Onision, so that means I deserve a video about my penis. Okay.
Tell us about him and drag and, you know, all sorts of weird shit, I imagine. You have a thing for Onision.
Well, I think Onision is a very creative and talented user on YouTube.
I'm sure.
Oh my god.
But I don't make videos about his penis. Why would you make a video about his penis?
In your mouth too, big man.
Why are you so interested in my penis for exactly?
Because it hurts your feelings.
It don't hurt my feelings. I'm just curious.
You flagged the video. So
you got proof or evidence to that?
Yeah, I do actually.
Okay, let's see it.
Okay. What was it? It was called. Oh no! Wait, let me see. That you also flagged the video where I made fun of you for lying about beating your wife. I'll actually let you upload that one too.
Hold on a second. I'll see if I can get that.
Let's see.
Every woman likes a good pounding every now and then in the vagina.
Oh, shit. God, this Manitoban has me broke.
I don't know who then now was, but it's like, you know, yeah. you don't give your money to Brett Keane, you don't donate to him, you don't, like, so why are you complaining? It's like people who don't go to church, but they complain that people are donating to the church. It's like, it's not your money, so who cares?
Oh, by the way, this guy right here, his name's Oni, apparently he made a 10-minute video about my penis. What do you think about that, honey?
Because I
don't think he's ever seen his penis, Mr. Oni. I have, and I think it's a rather wonderful penis. 17 years of experience, and 2 children later, I think he has a wonderful penis. I think I have room to make a video about Brett's penis.
He's like, oh, shit.
But you've never seen his penis, so you don't have the right to. So
I don't have the right to make fun of somebody. I don't have the right to make fun of somebody's erectile.
He's interested in me sexually.
Why not?
Not his genitalia.
Why don't I have the right to make fun of his erectile?
Because you've never seen it.
Because I've never seen it. So I can't make fun of somebody. I can't make fun of you being an ugly bitch. I mean, I've never met you in real life, but I'm doing it.
Okay. Sure, make fun of me being an ugly bitch, but I know otherwise.
There you go. I'm making fun of you, but apparently you somehow have a right to
Oh my god.
17 years and only 2 children, and what happened?
That's all the children we need.
I mean, you couldn't count a few more out of you, old bitch.
So, if you guys don't mind, Oni and the other guy that's giggling and stuff, do you guys label yourself as atheists? I'm just curious.
I'm not a day of money.
No, I'm a Muslim.
I'm not concerned about all that.
I like dick and vagina.
Well, I'm wanting to know if you guys that are sitting on the call with me right now actually consider yourself critical thinkers, rational thought, all that kind of stuff. Just curious.
I'm a critical thinker, but I'm not a skeptic. I'm not one of those people that's always, like, super skeptical. All right. You know what bugs me is when I see the word skeptic in a channel name, I'm like, oh no, another freaking skeptic.
Mm-hmm. What's wrong with the word skeptic?
There's nothing wrong with the word skeptic, but it gets overused in channel names. Might as well be the letter I in front of something like iPhone or iPad.
Okay. What word would you suggest to use other than skeptical?
Yeah, what would you think would be a reasonable one?
What do you have against the letter I? We have iCalintz in the call.
Okay. I skeptic, huh?
No. I skeptic.
Well, seriously, what would...
But yeah, you know what? Actually, hey, that would...
Break out your thesaurus. What word would you like to use other than skeptical or skeptic?
Oh. You know what? People do use their names to give people an idea as to what their channel's going to be about. And that's fine. So I understand it. It's just for you. Because you know what? Most of the time I find that a lot of the people that have skeptic in their channel name really aren't all that skeptical. I think it's totally bit evident by the kerfuffle going on in the atheist skeptic community. And all of a sudden, once it involves sex and feminism and harassment, you see that people on both sides of the fence throw their skepticism and rational thought right out the window. I think most of the time it's used unwisely. The person viewing isn't the skeptic.
I understand your thought on that.
This is Agent. This is Ravenous Wolf.
Right. I remember Ravenous.
Well.
I just wanted to say it was nice meeting you, gentlemen. I do hope you have a nice conversation, and hopefully talk to you guys another time.
Apparently, Ravenous and us are still getting married. Want to congratulate
them? Well, good for you. Congratulations. Don't let any rice fall on your eye, because it's supposed to be good luck.
Because
but it gets in your eyes, good luck.
May you, may he beat his wife as much as Brett beats you.
To an atheist.
May he beat you as much as Islam allows you to.
Ravenous, make more fucking videos, nigga. Make more bullshit videos. I can't really hear you.
You gotta fix your mic. Are you just gonna bark at us now? What the fuck?
Didn't Ash come back?
Yes, the douche bag is back.
Yeah, I just don't feel like chasing him to the end of the world. If he's going to leave all my friends alone, then, you know, I'm fine with him having another channel. And I would have been fine with him continuing on with the Fatal Error Network and making something of it. He didn't have to fucking kill the fucker.
Nothing was going to happen that. It's a piece of shit. It was always going to be a piece of shit, especially with him kind of at the helm of it.
Well, I didn't have a problem with him being that piece of shit of whatever he would have made of it. He didn't have to fucking kill it. You know?
It's not dead. The name is dead. The name is that all he owned was the domain name. Somebody else was paying for the server hosting. So all he had to do was pick a different name and attach that domain to where the site was being housed. But they started going all over the place. They weren't sticking with one focus-based principle, and they were making it overly complex. This is the sure way these things kind of die or they get crushed under their own weight. But number one...
Are you kidding? We so need another...
Save people from drama. Can't be putting out drama videos like 3 and 4 every freaking day and be the spokesperson for the drama-free Fatal Error Network. That was just laughable. That was laughable with him being the front man for that stuff.
I don't remember him ever promising that it would be drama-free.
Oh, no. You know, not drama-free. there be enough mechanisms in place to have conflict resolution and to allow these people to stay over there and those people to stay over there. What was actually being created was a troll safety haven, because you could be guaranteed that your trolly videos would never be taken down. So
he has a point.
What they were really creating was a website where you could just be a super troll and you know your videos would never come down. By the way, videos could still come down, and they really wasn't much of a mechanism to deal with immediately going to the legal end. On YouTube, we have the benefit of the largesse of YouTube at least providing some layer between us and legality. On their end, if something actually did happen, then boom, you're right, you're immediately in the realm of true legalness. Maybe you've got one letter of intent and then bam, you know.
Katrana, you're in the BlogTV. Send me an invite on Skype and I'll add you to the call. If you want to scream at any of us, we are pretty much the love soup of everyone who's hated on YouTube.
Nobody hates me. I'm not,
you know what? You are the emissary of Exiled.
I hate Exiled, so I hate you by extension.
Oh, by default?
Okay.
Yeah. You're so, the default setting on Alowlyapprentice is hatred.
Exactly. But the Godless is fucking hilarious. That dude needs to make videos.
You know what? Oh, there's something I won't forgive Godless for. I crafted this. We had this long comment exchange, and I got him to admit he was a racist. I made him, with using his own logic and his own words against them. And then he deleted the video. What did you do that for, man? That was awesome. That was so funny. Remember with the whole black market? The whole thing with the black market?
I don't remember. I'm black. Therefore, I forgive him for being a racist piece of shit. There you go. I have spoken.
You're black?
Yes.
Never would have thought it.
I would have.
So I have to have this icon to prove that I'm black. DM Crispin thinks I'm Hispanic.
Well, actually, I thought you were Aborigine, so.
That's right.
You know, does Aborigine count as black?
No, not really.
Not really? No? Well, then.
I don't, like, yeah. I can't see any of the other larger black groups saying, yeah, you're black, West Indians, Africans, African Americans.
The strangest people I've ever had to, like, think about how to classify them would be from Trinidad and Tobago. They are like a mix of everything, all into one person.
Oh, yeah. They're called humans, Agent.
Yes.
It was a really hard thing to grasp. But,
or you could say mutt, or you could say cholitas.
Yeah. I wanted to really troll DM Crispin with her thinking I was Hispanic, and I kind of just ruined it. Crap.
You know what? I added her to the call. She just fucking said busy.
Yeah, she's talking to her boyfriend.
Sabella, I guess I am a mutt. I am.
Sabella's here?
Oh. She's in the BlogTV.
Oh, the cock holder is still here, I guess.
So, Agent of Doubt, now that I can actually speak to you, what is your problem with Ashley Dakota? Because, like, she's my BFF.
Oh, no, that's just people that I know have a problem with me. I don't have a problem with those people. The whole, like, when I cut and paste that list into BlogTV, there was a phrase at the beginning of it, and I will bring it up. Here it is. People
aren't
pissed
with medical?
Me?
Yeah.
I barely know Mimica. Barely.
I thought you were friends with him. I'm sorry for cutting you off. Go ahead.
I've never spoken in person to the person, except for, I believe, on the periphery on this on a call like this. But anyways, people pissed at Agent of Doubt that AOD realizes are pissed. And that's that was the phrase at the beginning of, you know. And sometimes I don't know the reason, you know, per se, but I can pick up on, you know, generally the way that I'm being treated. You know? So
that's understandable.
I have a question.
Yeah.
Do you have, who's claiming the acronym AOD?
Oh, they have the rightful claim to it, Alliance of Demons. I just kept on being called AOD by everybody else's convenience, and it stuck with me too. I know it's confusing.
It is, actually, because I thought they were talking about Zerode, his circle jerk society, whenever someone says AOD.
Alliance of Dildos.
Hey, some of those are my friends.
Why?
They're a little zealous. They're just a little zealous.
I have no issue with the AOD as a group. It's just that they're such gigantic hypocrites that it irritates me.
Wow. You know what's funny is I don't have issues with them as individuals, but I'll have issues with them when they act as a group.
Alowly, you need to go check out Zerota's Tumblr and Thieves' Tumblr, and then
I unfollowed that stuff a long time ago. I was tired of seeing a stream of naked men and boys flow through my screen. I just said,
Well, they write blogs about, like, how they have former members that they have issues with and how they want to do stuff to them and, like, chop off their heads and shit like that.
Oh, and, for real?
Yeah.
I talked to them, and I knew things were bad, but I didn't know they were going public on Tumblr like that. I thought they would keep their feelings to themselves.
That's the shit that pisses me off, because they'll take, like, little wars and do that shit on Tumblr or blogs, and then they'll leak the information out to other people, because they know who the fuck, because when they fuck with somebody, they'll leak it out through Tumblr, but they won't make videos. They will, however, make videos from, like, troll accounts, and then they'll spam the shit out of their subscribers with those fucking troll accounts.
What subscribers?
I was one of their subscribers, and when they were going at it with Felita, they spammed the shit out of me with, like, troll account videos about how, like, Felita is evil and she wants to destroy God and all sorts of other ridiculous bullshit. I don't fucking piss me off. And they do that shit all the time. I can't fucking stand any of
The problem is, it's kind of like a headless monster. They all act in different ways. And it's with any organization or group of people, you know. You got your little rogues and your people doing things differently. But Agent of Doubt, you've noticed I call you Agent. I don't say AOD.
That's fine.
It's confusing. Plus, Agent, I think, is way cooler than AOD. And if you can get, like, Secret Agent Man in the, like, a theme, you know, part of the theme song. Part of
yeah,
opener,
see, here's the problem.
Or maybe The Prisoner.
When I made the name Agent of Doubt, I did not mean it in the way of, like, 007, okay? Fuck that shit.
I know what you meant.
You know, it's... It, they're...
He meant Rowan Atkinson, Agent, you know, giant English.
No. Nothing like...
A force of doubt or skepticism. A force, not like a person.
The thing that causes the reaction to be doubtful. The agent, you know, the...
Of course.
The bringer of it. The, you know, the... What brings about the doubt.
Skeptic.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, I'm back. I had to take my penis disorder to the toilet and use it.
That's funny.
It's got swamp on the ass.
Well, did you wipe off your wife when you were done, or what?
Oh shit, I hate Brett. The dude is funny. Oh shit, I hate Brett. The dude is fucking funny. He had me cracking up in the fucking chat.
Goodness, well, I'm relaxing right now. I'm not paying attention to text yet. Thank you for inviting me to Skype. I hate typing.
Typing does suck.
So, Sabella and Stigmadeign are quiet. They're probably fapping.
They're both looking. They're fapping to Narnia or. They're fapping to, like, little animals and shit on Narnia.
The Stigma's still on the call with us. I can't see the screen right now.
He is.
Yes and no, sort of.
He's kind of pre-whooped by his girl. She hasn't even... He hasn't even seen her in person for... ever.
Why haven't they hooked up yet and got married? Hold up.
I'm hoping he test drives that stuff, but you know he's a Christian.
Yeah. No.
Bear fruit multiply, isn't that what they're told?
Well, they're told all sorts of different contradictory stuff, and I think he might be one of those people that thinks that he needs to wait for marriage.
Go with the story of Onan, get in there and get it done. Yes.
I don't think he thinks that.
He needs to... What?
He might try, I don't think that works.
Holy fucking run, man. You can be like a bodybuilder to deal with that.
I just thought Sabella was there for him to put his dick in after he faps the porn and shit.
How long has he been going with Sabella? Is that the girlfriend he had that was in the video when the drunk women came home? And
no.
No. She was on video and he posted on YouTube.
No.
It was somebody else, I think.
Oh, okay.
Sabella is like some stalker that Mimica had like a long time ago or something.
So she's...
Wait, she stalked
Mimica? Like that. That's like trading in your Volkswagen Passat for a Gremlin.
If you were crazy and drunk and you thought everything was a conspiracy and you couldn't possibly get laid except by this one ugly looking crack whore on the street, hell, I'd jump on that shit too. I mean, what the fuck?
I'm assuming they've met. I mean, who gets married without having met?
Again, have you met Stigmadeign? The dude's fucking insane.
I know, but I don't think he's like that.
Brett has a fucking personality.
That's it. You're an atheist, which means one of the three dumbass.
Just look at it this way. He bapped to Dakota. And then chose Sabella.
Keep talking. One day
old man, let me talk to you. Let me say something to you. Old man, if you want to fuck with me, I'll shut your fucking foot down. Old man, fucking shove my fucking hand. Chest and rip your fucking heart out, you fucking bitch. Shut the fuck up, you cowardly piece of shit.
We'll go crawl back up with your mom.
Like I said before.
Oh boy.
Wish your mom had aborted. Then I wouldn't have to listen to you, your crazy ass on the internet talking about the government's coming after us and Obama's an alien or whatever the fuck.
Closet crony. I think that's why he's so upset. He can't come out of the closet.
Oh, we have one thing to say. Nimica is fucking the girl that Whistler were fucking. Ignorance and shut the fuck up. Yeah, I'm Sid Bidane. I'm a badass. Yeah, woman ass. Shut the fuck up, old man.
Stig, you're going to have to turn up your mic volume so we can hear you, or get closer to your mic.
Stig, you never got a new microphone? I thought you got your USB mic, man.
Look, you know, I step into the salvation for me. Get yourself a microphone.
It's the echo. It's killing me.
Agent, he can't turn up that microphone. It sounds like a Jimi Hendrix feedback guitar. All I hear is...
Seecide has never had a problem with about anyone, and...
I was disappointed, though, when she claimed to be Della and she wasn't. I was just really disappointed.
Okay.
Did anyone really think Della existed, though?
Della will always exist because anybody who knows about the situation will know about Della.
Wait, so is there an actual Della, or what? I'm just...
No, things have gone well at one moment.
Yes.
You guys heard that? I wish you could get your microphone fixed. That way you'd be more potent when you talk. Sounds like a chimpanzee being raped by a cat.
Stiggy, did you just threaten to shoot him in the head?
Or some preacher on the side of the road screaming about the end of time. Hurry up, I'm coming. I can barely understand what the fuck he's saying.
I don't know. It sounded like he's screaming into a pair of headphones.
I thought I heard that he was going to go get a rifle with a scope and shoot Brett. I thought I heard him say that.
That happened to the good old days when people used to change all the ways from it. Yeah, that's
what happened to the good old days with what? I didn't hear you. What did you say?
I was saying, when was the good old days? Where's the good old days when people used to use the old baseball bat to be up close and personal? Fucking sniper rifle.
Yeah, I agree. It's easier. It's easier to talk shit behind a gun, you know?
Yeah.
Well, did you say he wants to put a condom on a crucifix?
So, Stig, what have I done to earn a shooting, a homicide, a chalk line? What have I done?
I have a question. Why do you talk shit about Brett in the fucking comment section? Yeah, you don't say shit to him in fucking videos. I mean, you do this shit a lot. Because you used to do that shit to ass. You'd be like, don't talk to me! You make me angry! Like, every fucking chat and comment section, you talk about in endlessly. What the fuck is wrong with you? Are you my owner? Or are you just a bitch? Shit. Because it seems like the letter. I mean, if you have an issue with somebody, just say it. Don't be a fucking bitch and talk shit about them in comment sections.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I'm talking about you, Stig, since
you're a... You obviously don't know me. Because you're sitting there talking bullshit.
I'm talking... Okay.
If you were out there, you're no atheist, you just said it.
You're a sword.
Seecide.
Give her a chance to speak at least. Goddamn.
Movement like Freedom Found for Religion Foundation, if it wasn't for a bunch of butthurt people who didn't like it because somebody said, oh, well, this law indicates this because religious value. You just
what is he talking about?
And indoctrinated into society. So your only excuse to get away from them is, well, where there is God, it's totally illogical. You can't, a human being cannot prove something he has no control over. And you know, it's all
what
I think Steve lives in the Twilight Zone or something.
Plus, you don't have to think just to say there is no God or any evidence.
I have no control over taking a dump, but I can prove it.
See, you don't listen.
But you make the claim that there is a God. You always make things like that.
You understand, that's a personal belief. I'm not pushing it on anyone. Atheism upon everybody.
Join the dark side. Join the dark side. It'll be more
whether you agree with atheists or not, why do you feel like you gotta shoot them for a point of that?
Okay, hold on. I want to see something here. I'm just seeing something here. Okay. Everyone talk right now.
Oh, where did he go?
I hung up on him. I just wanted to see the echo would go. Man, that echo is fucking killing me. I don't know about you guys, but that echo is fucking killing me.
I'm not hearing an echo, so you need to.
And they both left at the same time.
Aww.
It's not left at the same
time. No, I hung up on him just to check to see that the echo was him. And it is him.
So it was Ravenous then, or whatever the fuck
that
goes?
Yeah.
I told you, I have running desktop speakers that ruin my head.
So, mute BlogTV from some.
Here's a suggestion, man. Listen, remember how you fixed it before? Just mute it whenever you're not talking. Instead, do that. Go ahead, man.
If you mute the BlogTV, everything will be fine.
Pretty much. That's the first thing I did when I jumped on here because I didn't want like there to be an echo in the room.
So let's hear from Lisa now that she's been in the call for like 10 minutes and hasn't said anything because all you...
Now, how many cheesy fucking headphones are you having?
All right, let's let Lisa talk. Corporal Magnum speak.
I can't curse. That's not fair.
Well, that's not my Magnum.
Go ahead, Lisa.
That echo is from Lisa.
Everybody so listen to him.
That's
not nice. The only female in the call.
I was always so I can't curse. All right. I feel as if my life is being just shackled down.
No, no. There's Brett. There's two of you.
You laugh like a fucking girl.
Amen to that.
That was the comeback. That was the comeback to me laughing after being a female.
All right, Mickey Mouse.
Okay,
relax.
Well,
how about Lisa talk?
Laugh about? Like a male then next time, would you?
Oh.
Oh. Well,
all right, Lisa, what's your story? Tell us all about it.
Yeah. What's your beliefs?
What's your
atheist.
You're an atheist? Congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
But only when the atheists are giving money, congratulations.
Right.
Oh. Oh, God, I'm just being
so hard. Go along with it. So, what's up?
Tell us why you don't like somebody in this call.
You are free to yell at whoever you want, Lisa.
The default person to hate is Brett, though.
Yeah. Get your whole show out there, Mr.
I want to know if Brett did something to all this, because I heard that he did something to all this.
What? Brett's
his channel.
Funny. I just got to say that.
Wasn't me.
It wasn't you?
Wasn't me.
No.
No, ma'am.
Everybody blamed
it.
We got the thing going. I'm like the...
He thinks it was you.
Brett's like the fucking Antichrist.
Yeah. It's...
No, just because Brett's a five doesn't mean he's guilty of everything that goes wrong in the world. Sorry.
I was joking. Calm the fuck down, woman.
Just 99% of what's wrong.
I'm about ready to stick my toe in your Oni.
You're about to stick your...
You might like that. Be careful.
Brett is too busy repopulating the world. Don't follow him.
You hush up there, A. I'll stick a toe in your A.
Oh shit, that's fucking funny.
He sounds so much like Sword, I swear he does.
Yeah, he sounds like our buddy Sword.
Who is Mr. Oni, you sound like
a Sword of Allah 87 before?
Oh, I've heard of that dude. That's the guy that TJ got into a fight with, isn't it?
Yeah, Sword of Allah is an extremely funny sound.
And you sound a lot like him.
Yes. Oh, that's
I thought you were at first.
Yeah.
But Brett corrected me on that piece of misinformation.
Yeah, he does sound
well.
I don't know.
Yes,
cool.
It does.
That's the dude, yeah. That's TJ got into a huge fight with. I remember that.
So, Brett, I do think it's important that we got to that because it seemed like why would... You know, crazy to the core flag your video when crazy to the core, like right when your video was flagged, he makes a response video where he's playing your video, and basically everything that you said comes up in his video.
You know? All I know is I have a strike against my account.
Yeah.
There's no way to be able to tell who did it. I don't know if all this flagged me. I don't know if Crazy did, because I don't know either one of them personally.
Or if one of their fans.
As far as I'm concerned, it could have been just some asshole that came over to the video and thought it was rude and fucking, you know what I'm saying?
To be honest, though, everybody flags Brett. I mean, it's fucking true. People hate Brett, so they do flag him. I mean, fuck. Because, you know, shit happens.
I blame Fake Sagan's as Mr. Canada feller there.
Fake Sagan needs to take the golf ball out of his mouth. Seriously.
Wait, Fake Sagan is Mr. Irrelevant, isn't he?
No.
Smooth terrorist.
Oh shit, he still sucks your cock though, Brett. You know that, right?
Hey, what?
Fake Sagan still sucks your cock, bro.
What do you mean he sucks my cock? I don't remember
that. That was... What's that one video he made where he said that TJ is a fucking thief? But then he said something about you're his buddy or something. After, I think it was before or after he called you slow. Let me fucking find it.
I think I remember your video. It's one where he's wearing the strange hat.
I think so. He said you were his friend or something. Hold on. Who the fuck is it?
If I had Fake Sagan on my fucking Skype, I would call him and we would have... more of a love soup. Hold on, I got a contact request from the James Pope.
Oh,
oh
shit,
God,
it's James!
Run for your life. Run for your life.
See that last video we put out?
I did not know that the James Pope was watching us.
Oh shit, that's my nigga James.
Son. Yeah.
He's black folk back in the day and everything. He's got the red hair, right?
Yeah.
How do you get the ability to do live stream? What do you got to do to get that?
It's a pretty good video. It's been a while.
Where is it? Justice.
He might have hung up. He might be, not there. But I did add him to the call right there.
So. I'm gonna have to take my leave. I did a poor job of representing Exile because I have no idea what her specific issues are, other than Brett, you know, you suck, major moose cock. Other than that, well, you and she and Stiggy had whatever, which I assume that shit was over.
Dude, this is like if somebody...
I don't mean to be rude, but,
Oh, shit. This
call.
Hey.
Hello, Mr.
What's up, Michael? How you doing?
I'm doing okay. I've been hosting this BlogTV call where we got all of the evil people that everyone hates all in one call, and everyone can join the call and scream at anyone else you want.
You're in that group by association.
Yeah, I'm just itching to go off on Brett.
Oh, well, we will return shortly. That sounds a lot of fun. Is the link to the BlogTV available anywhere?
I will give it in the Skype.
I'll let you guys talk.
Everyone hates you because of the times you defended TJ when, like, everybody was piling on him and shit.
Oh, me?
Yeah, everyone hates you for that shit.
I stand by that. I'll get up here and argue with all my haters if that's what we're doing. I have to use the restroom real quickly, though, so I'll be right back.
Any similarity between Brett and a human being is purely coincidental, just so everybody knows.
Says the guy in the Chief Dollar General mask.
Anyone who told you to be yourself couldn't have given you any worse advice.
Well, and says the guy who doesn't even show himself.
Are your parents siblings? Come on, you can tell us. Did your parents ever ask you to run away from home?
Now I gotta piss. Fuck.
Finally fixed his mic.
You ever wonder what life would have been like if you had gotten enough oxygen at birth?
I was wondering why you went so quiet. Would you Google all your fucking dope?
That's what I was thinking!
No, I Googled your mama.
You Googled your jokes.
You would think I'd dig up Brett's mom's grave or something. What the fuck?
Some of these I can actually remember. I've already remembered a whole bunch. Some of these are actually really old.
So without Googling it, why are you pissed off at me in the first place?
Hey, why don't you learn from your parents' mistakes and use birth control, bitch?
You're going to use jokes off of
Hey, these are straight from my heart, man.
Straight from your heart, though.
That Christian heart.
Yeah, I have to tell you, man, there's some bad news. You know, there's no vaccine against stupidity, so you're fucking screwed.
I hear you. Got proof of Jesus yet?
Your mama is proof of Jesus.
That's what I thought. No proof, man.
Do you have any proof that the position you hold as an atheist is true?
Isn't that the shock of God question?
No.
Oh, shit, it is, actually.
It is.
No, it's not.
Yeah, it is.
That's the same shit Shock used to say all the goddamn.
You have proof that the faith in the position you hold is true.
That's Shock of God, dude.
You know,
no,
you know,
I actually stand for an answer, that's all.
Come on, Wolf. Get your own material.
Are you asking if, like, do you have faith in the belief that there is no God? If that's what you're saying, that is what Shock says. That it takes faith to say there is so you don't think
God doesn't exist. There's a difference, dumbass.
Motherfucker, that's what I just said.
Well, it's not what you just said.
You've already explained what the word atheist means. One who lacks a belief.
Denies or disbelieves in a God or gods.
Don't drink yourself to death, Stan. Goddamn.
You know, if you want to, like, bring up that lack of evidence bullshit claim, you know, lack of evidence is the same thing as fucking having to deny or disbelieve something. It's also a non-statement.
Oh, shit, I guess that means I have to make
the concept of the existence that you can't remain in a state of lack of evidence. That's bullshit. It's just another fucking evasion.
Why does anybody believe in your God thing? You don't even believe in it. Listen to the way you talk and act.
You don't how can you logically say if you're an atheist, you do not know the entirety of the universe and all aspects of it, to include you calling yourself an atheist, which is the denial or disbelief of a God's existence.
Well, listen,
you have that God exists. What does he have that God exists?
There's no God. Atheist denies or disbelieves in a God.
I'm going to yell over everybody.
So how can you conclude to such a title without foreknowledge of the universe and all aspects of it?
What does that universe have to do with this? What the hell are you talking about?
You have to know all things to say that there is no God. You have to know everything about the universe to say there is no God or any evidence.
Can't you use the same, can I use the same argument against you and say that you have to know everything? This is fun.
To have faith that it is true.
I've always told you that I feel that the human race is infantile in its understanding of the universe, and I've also said that most atheists would be more than happy to believe in this shit if you could just simply provide evidence. So what's the problem? You guys still there? It went quiet.
I'm here.
Out the irrationality. Hopefully.
You were not pointing out anything irrational. You're saying that it's okay for you to believe in fucking God and it's rational. Shut the fuck up and stop interrupting everybody, you goddamn moron!
Everybody's speaking over everybody anyways, so shut the fuck up.
What the fuck are you speaking over everybody? Shut the fuck up!
Let me ask you this, do you believe in absolutes?
You do! Shit. You fucking believe in everything you accuse everybody else of.
I do think that you absolutely need to get a new microphone, if you want me to be honest with you.
Absolutely need to shut the fuck up.
that was actually pretty funny, I agree.
Rate Bob, you're in the BlogTV, and if you just add Agent of Doubt to Skype, I will pull you in this call, and you can scream at whoever you hate. We're all here. Everyone that people hate.
Come on in, the water's fine.
Yeah.
Since when does everybody hate me?
It's stupid, but it really works.
Oh, Lisa, nobody hates you.
That's because nobody knows me.
Well, Steve, hold your peace,
homie. Would you guys mind? Ask a biblical question to Mr. Werewolf.
He's going to yell at you.
If that's what he feels like doing,
I'm not going to answer you. I don't care what the fuck you have to say, Brett. Now, after all the bullshit that you pulled on me and fucking lied to people and started trouble between me and my friends, fuck you to hell, motherfucker.
Oh, started what, Trump? What are you talking about?
What are you talking about? Man, I ought to kick your fucking ass.
Oh, right, the sock account shit. I remember that. That's where he...
Motherfucker.
I remember that shit. Where Stigmadeign kept getting blamed for all the sock account and flagging attacks and shit. I remember that. That's what he's pissed off about.
Yeah, until I called her up one night and freaking hashed his shit out over the phone and talked about it. Yeah, and then he fucking made an account and then he fucking blew it by throwing it in his Brett Keaton blogs link on the fucking
you do realize.
So eager to fucking let everybody know about Brett Keaton blogs throws that fucking link around like it's fucking trash.
Okay, you do realize when we were getting along, you were having major fucking issues with Ashley the Raven and all these people. So what makes you think that I would have done something like that? Where's your evidence?
Fucking admit to it, you fucking puss bag!
Well, why is it that I have a video on my website where you admit that you did the sock account?
You're a fucking stalker!
Why is it that I actually have a video of you in your own words admitting that you were lying?
You dumbass!
Brett clearly has a more powerful microphone. What is the BlogTV link?
I gave it to you in Skype.
Oh, in another room. All right, sorry.
Oh, James returns.
I do. I have a big
group. You're too loud, am I, guys? I'm not trying to hurt anybody's ears here.
No. I wasn't implying that. Just that you were over talking to him.
It wouldn't be murder. It'd be fucking genocide.
Yeah, I remember that shit. That's
you got it.
Kind of what happened. I remember. So that's what you guys are like, just all.
Put me and Ashley as friends and all this shit, start trouble between her boyfriend and us. And he's trying, he's pretending he's my boyfriend. Bullshit.
Well, I actually did like you, Mr. Werewolf Man. I did dig you.
You fucking create drama so you can get fucking views, you sick, twisted bitch.
No, that's what they obviously told you, or what you convinced yourself of believing, but.
See, I get what Brett's doing. This nigga's actually pretty smart. He's actually planting little doubts in Steve's head. Ah, that's clever. I see what you're doing, Brett. That's fucking clever. I see you. I see you, nigga. That's
everybody
fucking clever.
Everybody missed this shit.
What are we talking about?
We're talking
like,
about Brett.
I'm letting people know, giving people an arrow on Google Earth, showing them where I live. It wasn't even the location where I live. Making them think. It was the Elvis Ballard Club or whatever.
Alright, what happened was, like, we don't,
cares,
I don't
a
know.
Bunch of people who never leave their house have the location to yours.
Someone was using sock accounts in framing Stigmadeign and going around, like, flagging the shit out of people.
This video was mirrored. It didn't even go for the original video, only because it was on my account, and it was, four easy ponies, of biotic gas. And all she was, all I was doing was refuting her argument about faith.
Well, I'll say it one more time, whether you believe it or not. I did not make any kind of accounts towards you. I've never dropped your docs or done any of these things. You are convinced of.
All kinds of people, because I made a video and fucking Matt uploaded on his channel, and it was about being saying that the fucking bombing of Hiroshima and Nagasaki were mistakes, and your original target was your mama's fucking steak.
That is not a good conversation at hand.
Does anybody remember me making a video talking about this man's mother or attack?
Does anybody remember you, period? What the fuck are we doing?
Who's this guy?
Listen, it's James Pope.
I'm James motherfucking Pope. I remember you trying to get me to, like, let you take my videos and re-upload them on your channel back in the day before you turned into a big heaping pile of shit. So don't be asking who the fuck I am.
Oh, shit.
I was just sitting here speaking highly of this guy before he comes into the call and now he's talking shit.
James, why aren't you this fucking vicious in your videos?
Ever invited anywhere? It's only outside somewhere.
I prefer James, to be more well-spoken in my videos.
I wish you were this fucking vicious, though. Holy shit.
Did
I like
you, did you say nice things about me, Brett? Because you have me blocked on every other social network.
I don't actually have sat there and talked good about you in the past.
Because, but I mean, like, you have me blocked on Facebook, YouTube, I think Twitter. You got me pretty well-rounded, like, blacklisted, like most people on YouTube, though. Nothing personal.
I never fucking blacklisted you. I mean, I know you don't know who the fuck I am, but I never fucking blacklisted. Well,
I do know who you are, and I enjoy your videos. I recognize your voice. I recognize your voice more than your screen.
Well, like I said, I never blacklisted you, because you're fucking funny as hell to me. I just wish you'd be vicious as fuck in your videos, though. It's fucking hilarious.
Well, I'll take the advice.
InventorGorilla.
Vicious about in this community, though. I mean,
I'm sorry that we even have any kind of confrontation, because the only person I hate in this room is Brett King, period.
No, bro.
I don't hate Brett. How could you hate Brett?
So I'll apologize to you if I offended you.
Inventor fucking Gorilla, take a fucking chill pill and quit fucking dogging on YouTube. We're all fucking on YouTube still. If you fucking hate it so much, you'd fucking leave, but you don't. You fucking emo fucking 40-year-old fucking emo.
Hey, fuck you.
Hey,
Angie. Fuck you too. Bunch of fucking whiners. Swag a flag, win. Fucking bitches.
Christian, welcome to the call where you can scream at whoever the fuck you want. We've collected all of the most hated people on YouTube and put them all in one call.
Freaking awesome idea.
Yes.
That is the default person to hate.
Because I pretty much don't get any attention otherwise.
John Paul Prime said he liked you.
John Paul Prime.
And who else? Fucking. Comments to myself. John Paul Prime said he liked you, and...
Have I redeemed myself, John?
He said you were a talented young man or some shit like that. I don't know. I think he was hitting on you or something.
Y'all never forget the first time I met Brett, although I keep trying.
That was funny the first time, dude. Not the second.
I have a feeling like it was probably before.
So what the fuck, Brett? Why'd you remove me from Skype again?
Because you get boring, man. You never talk.
Yo, whatever.
Metal Black.
You're always fucking busy, man. I like to chat with people who fucking don't got no life.
Bullshit.
Turn your fucking life upside down and make it
I was gonna call you tonight from the studio, dude, and I'm like, what the fuck? You removed the contact.
Well, when you want to chat with me, have me in context. That's why I used to talk to Mr. Stigmadeign. He ain't got no life.
Whatever happened to that fat bitch J-Dubs, anyway?
Who?
No, J-Dubs. Whatever happened to him?
Brett 80.
He crawled up Brett's ass and just said no one's seen him since.
Hiding him under my turtle shell.
I actually didn't mind one of his videos.
Yeah, Brett's nobody's cool piece of paper. Someone will adopt him.
I'm eating nachos.
You're eating nachos?
Yes.
You know what? Are you eating your delicate fucking pansy nachos that you put in the fucking oven? How the fuck are you gonna say that you like the crunch of nachos and you put the fucking cheese on the nachos anyway? Make your fucking dip separate from your fucking chips.
Oh yeah. No, he's right on that.
But you don't have to if you use the oven and you don't overcook it.
That depends on what kind of dip you're using by a long shot.
Okay, wait, y'all can't monopolize the fucking conversation with talks of dips and shit. Nobody gives a fuck about that. This is a hate party. What the fuck, man? This is a fucking hate party, man. This is hate. This isn't like, yo, guys, let's talk about dip and Cheetos and video games.
Hey, I just have the cheating fucking nachos, okay? That's all I said.
We're nacho hating, dude. We're hating on his nachos. You're not exosteric enough to fucking not say
they're fucking Taco Bell nachos. They're
Taco Bell nachos.
Yes, they're horrible.
Christian, I want you to know something.
Can I get some hate? I feel kind of left out.
Christian, I took a trip to Grand Junction, which means I crossed the Great Divide on the continent, and I took the opportunity to get out of my fucking truck and take a piss on a tree because I knew that on that side of Pike's Peak, eventually my piss will get into your fucking groundwater.
Riff Randell hates you.
That's why I will never tell you where I live.
Riff hates you for the Occupy shit. He still hates you because of that.
He hates me over that? I mean, that seems like so ridiculous.
Everybody...
I mean, like, so that kind of, like, isn't that, like, extremely ironic, given the community that we're in? Like, you know, he hates me over a conversation we had. That seems a little ridiculous to me. You know, the whole point of our community on YouTube is that we're supposed to be able to discuss this thing without vitriolic hate being spewed about, but whatever. I'm not sure if that's even true. I'd have to hear him say it.
I know he says, you know, like, you know how fucking Riff is, right? He'll fucking say something nasty about you in his videos, like, offhandedly.
That's what started the whole debate, is he referenced me offhandedly in a little post, but I mean, I don't actually watch his videos. I've heard he has a new channel. I'm not aware of what it is called, though.
Oh, Cardinal Virtues. I'll just link you to it, but I know he still
hates you. No, I don't feel obligated to do that. Who
is Christian Inventor Gorilla, and why are you asking for my information?
That's me. That's you. I don't want to fucking stalk you and kill you in your sleep.
He loves your sexy fucking voice.
James, the person that you both have in common is Shayra. There's only one degree of separation between the two of you. Well, between you and Inventor Gorilla. Shayra.
Cool.
Yeah.
And, you know, Shayra's not bad, dude. I've talked to her on Skype, and she's not bad.
Shayra's the shit. Good friend.
Yeah, but you know what? She belongs in this call, too, because...
James has a really sexy fucking voice. I'm sorry, he does.
Even though she presented a bullshit argument, at least I got a
shot. Had me, too, on.
Of course. Damn, you have a sexy voice. Holy shit, I don't have
Well, you know what I mean? I think Shayra gets as many views as she does, because she's got those... Tingle bitties.
She does have tingle bitties. There's
no okay, we gotta. We can't talk about Shaver's tits if we're gonna hate on each other, because we're all gonna fucking agree on that.
I know, yes.
I'm fucking at it, James.
Comrades and Shaver's tits.
I'll fucking jack off to him later.
Yeah, no, you guys are jacking off my voice now, alright? Let's stay focused.
Wait, were you trolling him by saying his voice was sexy?
Hell no. It fucking is. Hey, I played for both teams. Fuck you.
I agree.
What are you talking about?
There's a girl on this call?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Hi, Lisa.
Actually, she's
Hi.
She's the token tip.
How did you get wrapped into this?
I have no idea. I just came to the BlogTV, and before I knew it, I was in the call.
People hate you for any reason, or are you just yelling at Fred?
No, but you hate Lisa. Everybody loves Lisa.
Question is, should we?
So, anybody who's ever been accused of flagging people, Eden's Cancer wants to know, I'm not going to get false flagged for being here, am I?
Oh shit, Eden's Cancer is here.
Give us
yes.
a link to her channel.
Oh wow, fucking invite him to the call.
I'm tempted
well,
to just
he can add me on Skype and get pulled into the call, but his fucking name on BlogTV is his fucking channel name.
I actually want to fucking flag him. Let's all flag Eden's here.
Yeah, it'd be kind of funny to do that now, wouldn't it? We have to pick a very tame video, though.
Let's flag down his Occupy Wall Street videos and then blame it on fucking Riff. There you go.
Blame it on Riff.
Yeah.
Like every... Oh, shit. Do that shit to TJ. And just watch the fucking fireworks.
I don't even understand how flagging like works. It seems like to me, like somebody as controversial as TJ, with as many views as he gets, should get flagged down every video.
He's a partner, and he has a lot of insulation because of his partnership.
Yeah, I'll never be part of it, so I don't know.
You know what? Yeah,
you have the sexy voice.
You know what? Earlier, we actually worked it out. You could make partner with $300. $300 fucking dollars, and you can make partner for any channel.
What? Tell me now.
Okay.
Ow.
You know the YouTube promotion tool where you fucking put money in the fucking AdSense and you fucking pay to get your videos promoted?
AdWords, but yeah.
Yeah, the AdWords. Fucking set that shit to 1 cent per click so that you maximize your fucking money. Then you fucking promote some of your fucking videos. You're going to need about 30,000 fucking views within a week, right?
Yep.
If you average 1,000 views per day... You can get picked up by a dozen different networks. All you gotta do is put in fucking $300 fucking dollars, fake the funk, because Google isn't telling them that you paid for those views. You can even have those videos monetized and get some of your money back.
Yep. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna be.
How much money do you say you have to spend? So $300.
It depends on how many views you get. On your own. If you're one of those people who, you know, gets like 300 a day and you need to, you know, pump it up to 1,000 a day, it's going to be a little bit cheaper for you. But all you got to do is get one video that gets 30,000 views to make your average over the last 30 days 1,000 a day.
Oh, I see.
And the cheapest way to fucking pay for that would be $300 and set it to 1 cent a click. You could fucking fool any one of these fucking networks except for like Machinima, who have like higher standards to get in. But there's all these fucking new ones.
Because you see, I'm going to flag every fucking video he puts up out of spite.
Dude.
When his video goes down, you know,
why you gotta fucking flag things?
If you flag, I have to say this shit. When you flag Brett, you actually give him credibility to say, oh yeah, they're picking on me and singling me out. That's the problem, though. But when you do that shit, you make everybody think that the shit Brett's done isn't, you know, is overblown or not true. And
when you hear, oh, Brett's channel was flagged now again because he was being a fucking douchebag, you'll have me to thank.
I love how much whoever that was just doesn't give a fuck about what anyone else is saying. Just like, no, you shouldn't do that because it actually doesn't help our point. When you get his flannel, you just tag down again, you can thank me. Just completely ignoring the rest of the like conversation.
Kyle, welcome to the
this motherfucker pulled.
Welcome to the group. You should introduce yourself, and then anyone in this group you can scream at if you have a problem with them, myself included.
The default person to hate is Brett. You have to hate Brett, everyone.
No, you can hate IG, too.
Okay.
You can hate IG.
So, IG, are you going to be sticking around?
Brett, thus saith the Lord.
Of course I am, dude. I'm going to go for partner. I'm going to go for partner, Kip.
That was the 11th commitment.
Well, I'll tell you what I'll do for you, Stigma. Keep watching your videos while you flag me. How's that?
Self, shut the fuck up.
Hey, guys, don't get on to him. He's just showing his Christian love. Leave him alone.
That's what I'm talking about. Brett likes it when you do that shit to him because he can just turn it on you.
Yeah.
I don't think
it's a problem. No, don't. It really does hurt my feelings. I'm tears in my eyes as we speak.
Hey, Brett, what were you doing before they called you?
Before they called me?
Yeah.
What was I doing before they called me?
You washed
the
dishes. As a family.
You're watching.
What happens in the day to day life of Brett King?
Eating and touching my
toes.
Wow.
What goes on?
Daily beatings. Daily beatings. Go.
So talking about cock beating?
Because you want to put out your nasty, sorry ass.
Talking about, like, beating off?
Daily beatings of his wife. I think that's kind of
that's a mean thing to say. Is that true?
Right? James, please stop on this. Because, god damn, your voice is sexy.
Yeah. Having a hard time hearing pretty well at the same time like that.
No, you're not.
I
am. You're lying. You don't want to respond to me. Just. Sorry, I'm a
bad. Well, yeah, it's the thing you like. I'm listening, but let's try to do it one at a time.
Oh, no.
He's just possessed by a retarded ghost.
A retarded ghost? Casper with Down syndrome is possessed Brett, apparently.
Hey, shout out to iCalintz. What's up, Brett?
What's up?
Nigga, that's me.
You're iCalintz?
Yes!
Oh my god, I didn't know that.
There you go. Hell yeah.
Holy shit, I had no idea. No, I totally. Wait, what? What? Oh, what's up, man?
Who's licking each other? We can carry on with this conversation.
No, I got a little bit more licking. Just shut the fuck up. Me and him are licking. We got actually have quite a bit of licking to do, so you can all start a new call, and we're going to continue licking each other.
Okay. And leave the call. Licking each other.
Look, man, just because the only thing you have at night is your fat, ugly girlfriend.
Funky down there.
Oh, no, you went there. You went there.
Damn.
Damn.
Ouch.
I feel a little heat from that burn. That was bad.
I should flip that joke around earlier about the woman making $250.50.
Oh,
You say that was Brett mom, Brett's mom.
Really?
She had to go prostitute, whore herself around for money. She got $250.50. Who did she get the 50 cent from? All of them.
Your mom is so fat.
You're in the bong hit. Who's smoking the bong hits?
That's James, nigga.
I got a bowl.
Yeah,
I'm actually sitting on a fucking dime and a half a week.
Dude, I can't believe you didn't know it was me, though.
Later.
I didn't know. I had no idea.
Shit, sorry. I'm glad you know now. Let me add you.
You're the same person.
Yeah.
I've seen you around YouTube as Oni Kubo tons of times, but I've only ever, like, chatted, like, typed with their iCalintz, you know, BlogTV. My God, I'm talking about you like you're two different people.
I'm gonna add you now, because, you know. Let me add you to Skype.
So, Kyle just fucking dropped without saying a word. I think his mic might be broken. He's actually Spiritual Bully on YouTube. Oh well.
What is his name?
Yeah, I dropped. My internet connection is kind of shitty. I dropped and I came back. I'm gonna have to get it installed this week.
Anybody else? Oh, let me throw this out here on a group full of people. Anyone else been having, like, buku fucking flash player issues the last 24 hours?
Yes.
I have. Yeah.
Yes. Okay, so it's not just me. All right, that makes me better. I was getting so pissed off my computer.
Adobe has an update.
I went and reinstalled and updated, and I don't know. I'm just going to leave it on 280p here for a little while until this goes back.
What the fuck is with you and subjects that we all get along on? You know we're all fucking YouTubers. We all have fucking YouTube problems.
James, I have to say this shit. Let's go fucking flirt in another fucking room.
I'm sorry, that twice.
You should, like, flirt with Brett. He would love it.
Oh, God, I just threw up in my mouth. Don't ever say shit like that to me.
See, he's into that kind of thing.
Oh, shit.
Here?
Yeah, he's still here.
Later, I'm just sitting here chilling.
Chilling. Brett. So, wait, no, Brett, are you still Christian?
He's like a chameleon.
For a very, very long time now.
If he's a Christian, I'm fucking God. Are you kidding?
No. Seriously, though, Brett, do you identify as a Christian?
No.
No. Oh, no. So when did that change?
He's a God hater now.
So like, I saw a few videos.
You were straight up. He basically went through a transition of agnostic theist and then atheist.
Okay, so.
Turn my videos.
Basically, you couldn't scam any money out of Christians, so you were like, fuck it, I'll just go back to pretending I hate God, even though I don't give a fuck about anything anyway.
I mean, come on, yeah, no, Brett, let's be real.
Well, Brett, come on,
I would love you so much if you just straight up were real about it, and you're like, you know what, yeah, dude, yep, yes, that's exactly what I did. I was like, I fucking was fed up with all you bitchy atheists. You can word it however you want. You can make us sound like the bad guys, but you did do that shit because the Christians gave you money. Come on, just say it.
Why don't you go ahead and show a video where I actually say I'm Christian?
See, that, nobody gives a fuck about
that. Up? Somebody can pull that up right now.
I can't. One thing though, Brett, it doesn't even matter if you get a video or not, because everyone knows you're so full of shit, you'll just change your mind whenever somebody gives you money. Because you're a whore, and you have no sort of ethics or values or self-respect.
You know what? Do
whatever.
I'm the same. You know, I'm a whore.
Earlier we were talking about how certain arguments don't work because Brett just turns them around back on
you. Yeah, we would all.
And I mean, it's to a degree, guys kind of are doing that exact same thing to yourselves. Yeah, I mean.
But not all of us fit our heads up our asses that far.
Well, if you actually believe that I referred to myself as a Christian any time recently or in the past couple of years,
like about 6 months ago.
Why don't you be honest and refer yourself
about a year and a half ago? You're obviously, James, you're talking about a year and a half ago.
Wow.
A year and a half ago, I asked for people's help. And a bunch of religious people actually came forward and tried to help. However.
Hold on.
What's he saying? Let me finish.
What ended up happening was there was some religious folks as well as some atheists who did help. One of the atheists was Pat Kendall, the other was Tommy from the Bronx.
Didn't you read Pat's private letter on the fucking internet and then talk shit about him after he gave you advice?
Well, you sat there and made it sound.
So you're saying that I'm wrong in this interpretation of that? About a year and a half ago, asked for some help from people, but not a lot of help came from atheists, and it seemed as though, through the interpretation I took of your video, that you had made the decision to abandon the atheist community and to join up with the Christian community.
No, I did not say that I abandoned the atheist community.
Well, no, you didn't say you abandoned the atheist community, Mitt Romney. You didn't say that word for word. But you said you made the implication that you were not of the atheist community and that you were of the Christian community, that you had some hard thinking to do about the ideals.
No, I did not say that I was disassociating myself or getting away from atheism. I've always liked to believe in deities. For one time, a long time ago, when I was younger, I was brainwashed.
Constantly talk shit about it, man.
What happened a year and a half ago? You asked for help. One of the people's passed them down. Blah, da, 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 da. What am I getting wrong in that situation? What did you say? What did you say if you didn't say that?
A year and a half ago, I was asking for help as my wife and I were having a situation where a bank was...
I already know about all that part. And then...
Yeah, you were beaten there. What else?
We ended up losing the home and ended up moving.
Because you beat your ass.
In the video. Does anyone have that video yet?
Yeah, go ahead. See if you can find it. There's trolls out there that have made videos claiming that I went to be a Christian and all that.
Hey, come on, somebody's got it.
It doesn't matter. It doesn't fucking matter if we show you videos or not, because he'll just deny it or say, oh, they edited me out of context because I'm an idiot.
Go ahead and try to find a clip where you supposedly...
You got plenty against everybody.
Oh my god, I'm going to do this myself.
You got everything on your website because you're a fucking internet stalker.
I mean, and like... You know what, fuck this. I want to hear Stigmadeign go after Brett some more. Fucking unload on this motherfucker.
Okay. Gonna give you guys an opportunity to go look around, see if you can find a clip where I actually say that without a troll sitting there.
If a thought ever crossed your mind, Brett, it'd have to be a long and lonely fucking journey. If you had another fucking brain, it would be lonely and blow itself out.
I could go over to Google right now and find a bunch of cute jokes too. There, Stigma, can you use your own?
I could make a monkey out of you, but I wouldn't take all the credit. Fucking shit slinging fucking piece of crap.
I'm gonna find this video.
Wow.
Everyone keeps like a record on Brett's video, so fuck it. It should be like easiest part to find something on.
It should be, you know.
So, hey Bruce, how do you reconcile the way you speak to and about Brett Keane with your Christian faith?
Very carefully.
That's a good answer. Very carefully.
Really?
Well,
Brett had a brain transplant, but the brain rejected him, you know. Yeah, if you don't want to track the show on, please don't ask Brett how old he is, because he can't count that high yet. So it's going to take hours for him to get that high.
Alright, I have all these old fucking videos.
Oh, we almost got to another bong rip from James. Somebody said that high, and I was like, where's James with the bong rip?
Brett, do you want people to accept you as you are, or do you want them to actually fucking like you?
I just want to be able to upload my videos and express my opinions.
So you just want to continue being a fucking asshole, douchebag, right?
Brett, I don't get this whole, I'm just an innocent YouTuber and everybody's picking on me bullshit. Dude, Why do you even fucking want that fucking persona? Be an asshole and be like, no, I don't give a fuck about any.
That's what I'm saying. You know?
Seriously.
Okay.
You know, that's what I fucking do.
People would fucking have to respect that you fucking own that shit. You know, but then you play the victim after, you know, thousands of people watch you false flag fucking, you know, Coughlin in a video, and then you want to bitch about being false flag, and it's like, what the fuck, man? At least own
it. Coughlin was the Coughlin, that video with Coughlin, was the only character came out and did something like that. And the reason why I did that to Coughlin is because he sent his little assholes over and destroyed a 10,000 sub account army.
I want to specifically turn people against
the kid. That aren't fucking
back and watch fucking content explode. And then you fucking capitalize off of it, making videos off of it, spreading it around just for your own fucking views. That's what kind of person you are, man.
If I was doing any of the shit that people are claiming, I'd be more than happy.
All somebody's got to do is fucking let loose napalm with your ass. He would just stomp your fucking ass all over the place.
Well, we'll get popped on Saturday, actually, along with Fury.
Fucking gears, man, fuck.
Hold on for one second.
He talked to napalm and Sister Sunshine at the same time, because they were such good friends.
I have to, one second. Brett, seriously, I'm not even fucking with you. Why don't you just own the fucking negative reputation you have instead of being like, I'm an innocent YouTuber, blah, 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 blah. I fucking do that shit. I mean, hell, I said rude shit to everybody up in here.
Yeah, I understand what you're saying, man. I get you on what you're saying. But if I sit here and I go along with the bullshit, then that would be fucking lying and deceptive.
Brett, you were in Skype with me and Happy Cat. You were whining to Happy Cabbie about your fucking videos, and you were getting him to contact YouTube staff, the moderators that actually review the videos, so you can get your fucking videos appealed. You're a lying piece of
shit. Oh, shit.
Well, actually, Stigmadeign, Sparky.
One gives a fuck about Stigmadeign or J-Dubs. So when they say shit, he's like, he doesn't care because no one gives a fuck about what these two idiots say anyway. I mean, that's basically it.
Who are we calling?
We're sorry. Your call cannot be completed as dialed. Please check the numbers and dial again.
James.
What'd you do? Call Brett's brain?
No, he called Napalm, but Napalm's not answering.
Oh, Matt. Hello, Matt.
Yo, can you reach out with Cardinal Virtues? Because Rift is on now.
You guys familiar with BloggerDome?
That's a Mendim site, isn't it?
Yeah, that's where Napalm does his videos nowadays. If you go over there and check, you send him a message.
I didn't fucking know that he. So he does still make videos. He just. Why doesn't he tell anyone that he makes videos?
Well, he does. He has a channel. He does videos every now and then telling people to go to BloggerDome, but he doesn't want to use YouTube as his main source of doing videos. Me and him are actually posting videos on Gary's site and shit left and right. If you take a look, BloggerDome, that's what it's called. If you get a look.
Does he post on his videos?
Right, the happiest motherfucker alive. Ignorance is bliss. That's all there is to it.
This dude is hilarious.
Sit there and just bullshit people continually on and on and on, battling your fucking lying bullshit.
Dude. Extraordinary claims require extraordinary evidence.
Amen.
Everybody knows what the fuck you did to people. And don't sit here and try to fucking cover it up. Most of them have busted you on it. You fucking know it.
Busted what?
All your fucking lying and deception, all your fucking shit about breaking up friends.
I hear a lot of this stuff about lying and deception.
And then you fucking sitting around talking about it like you had nothing to do with it. And then you're on fucking Skype with Happy Cappy, fucking having him call up YouTube staff moderators, getting them to appeal your videos and flag people's videos down.
You know what? You know what I gotta say about that? I gotta say, you know what? More fucking power to you. You know, if you can get someone on the inside to fucking give you a hand, you know,
but he was
well fucking done.
One sec.
Fucking bitch about it. You know, it is what it is. That's no reason to fucking assassinate his character because he fucking shit looked at.
Hold on, one second. IG, that's pretty fucking twisted, though. Aren't you on fucking Fatal Error Network for that? You were on Fatal Network. What the fuck ever that site was called to prevent this type of shit? That's a pretty twisted
thought. That's not why I was there. And don't fucking tell me why
I thought that's why you were there. I'm just saying.
No, I was there. I was there because I was sick of my shit getting false flagged. I wanted a place where I didn't have to worry about it. And shut up for a second. And the reason why I liked Fatal Error Network is because the moderators, which I was one of them, everything was reviewed. That's why no other reason. Was because videos were actually reviewed.
Alright, my fault then. Never mind.
You know, and I'm saying, hey, if you got a connection to get on the inside at YouTube and get your shit reviewed, more fucking power to you.
It just seems kind of shady to me the way it's done.
He was
sitting
in a report of abuse link, but he was kissing Happy Cabby's ass in order
well,
to fucking...
Well, I kiss his ass too, so
look
what?
Look at it, sir.
So I, you know, I kiss Happy's ass too. You know what? He's helped me out a fucking ton. So what?
I mean,
by the way, Inventor, I do know that it was important to you to have a place where you can put your videos if you feel you want to.
The point is, that's the problem. Happy Cabby was misusing his fucking power as your fucking partner. And because
he was misusing his power by sending him.
So don't fucking try to.
You're just saying he didn't help you out. Shut your damn pie hole.
Okay, one second.
Why are the two Christians in this group call arguing over Happy Cabby's powers that he doesn't even fucking have?
If you believe
that Happy Cabby has fucking powers on YouTube, no wonder you're a Christian.
Earth people.
James and a Christian have anything to do with
it. James posted to a Christian video, by the way.
Look,
explain to me how us being Christians has anything to do with it.
Guys, I know most of you probably aren't going to sit here and listen to me on this, but I'd appreciate it if we can just keep Happy Cabby out of the situation. If you want
to. Okay, shut the fuck up. Nobody gives a fuck about that.
Don't go after him.
I'm sorry, but
nobody fucking cares about not slandering Happy Cabby. Fuck that fat bitch. He says shit.
Yeah, I'm right alongside with you.
Seriously. Fuck that fat motherfucker. Happy Cabby is so fucking toothpaste. Nobody fucking cares about, like, not, you know, not offending him. Toby Toby's my friend. Fuck him. Fuck him and fuck me, Bravo. Seriously.
Oh, all this shit this third saying anyway is bullshit.
I mean, shit.
Happy Cabby saved my YouTube channel.
Yeah, seriously.
Seriously. Nobody fucking cares about that dude, man.
Oh my god, that was good. You said that.
That's how I can laugh. That's me. That's
oh my god, that was funny. I was listening to this ridiculous shit. Do you guys do this often?
You guys still haven't shown a clip of what you were claiming earlier about the
in the BlogTV.
You're still working on it?
You're still working on it, yeah.
James posted them in the BlogTV, fucker. fucking link to BlogTV. That's where they are. You can post it from there.
What are these three links for?
Who is that?
That's Brett's wife.
Oh, hello. Good evening. Whoa, wasn't expecting that.
Actually, I wasn't either, because your voice sounds different than all.
Yeah, because my voice is tired. When I get tired, my voice starts changing.
Because, like, my voice sound completely different. Holy shit.
When God made bread, he's the blueprint for idiot.
What? I love this shit.
There he is, infatuated with my dick again.
What's wrong with a little dick infatuation?
I have dick infatuation. James, your icon for Skype suits you, man. I love that shit.
Ionic made that. YouTube.com/TheIonicOne. Everyone's to subscribe to him.
Yeah, Brett, believe it or not, you know, he's living proof that a man can live without a brain.
Bowl or...
I'm laughing at the laughter, dude. It's a laughter to drag
so
me
stupid. Up. I mean, the jokes are so fucking stupid.
Y'all need to respect Rakeem. He's been on YouTube since 2005, so just bow down before Yoda.
So have bugs and glitches, but who the fuck cares?
And he's fucked up every day since.
On the sleep, yeah.
So, James, I just checked out all three links. There are two other YouTubers who are commenting about Brett Keane converting.
Well, yeah, I addressed that in the chat prior to the links.
Their links in the chat.
Okay, so all these people saw it. That's what you're saying.
That's the point, yes. What I was trying to make.
Brett can't convert.
I do have to give you one thing, though, Brett. I do have to give you one thing. There are a lot of stupid-ass videos up about you. I amazed at the amount of attention you receive from these people that claim to hate you. I mean, it seems more like a fan club. I mean, I wish I had people making as many videos about me as they're making about you. Jesus, Mary, just trying to find a video of Brett Keane's is so difficult because you have to sift through all the videos about Brett Keane. And
you would think this would translate into huge views and some sort of popularity, but he gets like 2 views per video. It's fucking
everybody knows it would probably take only about 10 seconds.
No, seriously, they got a point on that side, too. It's like, if anyone I know goes out of the way to make, like, you know, to just kill all the publicity they get and just make the most god-awful, boring videos in the world, it's gotta be that. Jesus Christ, you're talking about that shit for like 15, 20 minutes at a time.
Hey, I got a scam we
Hello,
can pull
ladies and gentlemen.
Hear it.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is our game.
Oh shit, I get back into my account and look at it. I was coming up with a trolling scam. Get 20 people together, and each of them get about 10 to 15 sock accounts. Then you just make a bullshit minute or two video on every account, and have everybody on every account fucking thumb it up, leave one or two comments.
Everybody,
hitting the view button, 20 different people.
Everybody,
so
welcome.
Like Alliance of Demons Secret, like how
oh
they
God,
pay 20
I
accounts.
Oh, shit.
Hate.
Hey, what's going on, people?
He's doing it like it's a job in order for it to work.
They
can hardly get 20 people together to make a fucking video for marriageevolved.com or gay rights or to fucking like do any kind of fucking thing. You guys are getting groups of people together to make groups of sock accounts to fucking flag some video that nobody's ever gonna watch in the first place.
No, it's now. Why don't they just do a better idea where they can actually make some money off of it?
Everybody.
Oh, this is a money-making scheme.
Everybody, Unworshipedeity has just joined the call. Unworshipedeity, please go fucking get some mouthwash because I can smell your dog semen breath through the fucking internet.
I personally like dog semen. It's better than cat semen and bull semen.
Well, that's creepy. Anyway, James.
I mean, you could basically create a troll thing and feed the trolls bullshit videos and let them have all the comments they want. I mean, look at the guy at Krispy Kreme.
Hey.
He knew what he was doing when he put that fake snot in his nose in that first video. He knew he was going to get millions of fucking views. That dude's a fucking genius. Think about it.
James, I want to talk to you about something. This is iCalintz. After this fucking call, I want to talk to you about an idea I just had that furry wolfman or what the fuck ever his name is just said. I want to talk to you about something.
What?
I want to talk to you about something. Ravenous gave me an idea.
Not like we're talking about anything important.
Alright, that's true.
let's
fucking do that shit. Let's do with it what Ravenous suggested to us. Like, bullshit scams. Let's do that shit.
Get a whole bunch of people together. Each of them having several sock accounts. Each all subscribe to each other. Have one main account per person and put up videos and constantly go view them and thumb them up and give positive comments no matter what they have to say.
Why? Why does this guy keep revealing a lance of demons secret?
Once they spread it around, get more people involved, get more subscribers to the main accounts.
I don't feel like that's a good way.
Gather all the
effort in making quality videos.
Everybody involved in the project.
Yeah, who was that in the faint distance? Like, why don't you just make good videos? That's
now, this is about actually provoking views and forcing views and forcing
YouTube. I mean, I hear you, and like, I agree YouTube doesn't shine the spotlight around, and sometimes you gotta do things like this to get the right viewership. I'm not, like, totally against it, but it's like, what you're sounding like, what you're explaining, if I'm just gonna respond seriously. It sounds like way too much manpower for the amount of views that you would actually get out of it.
Right.
I mean, just a network of people is not going to gain you that kind of views. You need some kind of an automated system, which you can purchase from my channel, youtube.com/PopeApprove.
look, on Sunday, when they allow you to speak at the front of the church service, you just get up there and shout out your YouTube link, and hopefully people will view you.
I don't get it, church.
That's awesome.
I like the real
wait, you don't go to church?
It's like, I don't go to church.
I go to church.
Church smirch.
Bruce, aren't you afraid of going to hell?
Let me put it to you this way. I have a problem going into a building that a person will wear clothing that is more expensive than how much they actually put in the offering plate.
Oh god, this is a bit too self-righteous for a guy who just threatened to shoot Brett in the head. I'm just saying, man.
I mean,
I think somebody kind of agree with
all
him
the problems that you have with the church. I mean, really, that's the top of your list.
That's why.
I mean, what about the little boys got stuffed under?
No, there's a lot of
fast clothes.
There's a lot of hypocritical stuff that goes from churches. I don't.
Yeah, you know what? There are a lot of churches. There are a lot
there's
of churches.
Drama about bills and all this, and people judging each other. You know, about, oh, they're driving a new car, but they don't put enough money in the plate. Yeah, but you're wearing a fucking Armani suit, and you only put $20 in the plate, so shut up. You know, I don't want to deal with that kind of shit.
Yeah,
and then the curtain's going to be, and, you know, and plus they start sitting on each side of the church, like, this group of people's pissed off disparate people, and they want donuts served in a different fucking room every month. You know, fuck all that shit.
What the fuck are you talking about? Donuts? Hey,
donuts?
You're talking about your own little backwoods church there? I mean,
yeah, Judge, those times.
And on Tuesdays, they have the great donut debate, and it's just kind of.
Thou shalt not make Krispy Kreme with Dunkin' Donuts.
Yeah, what the fucking coffee donut that dude got me? That's the last supper. You're supposed to go have unleavened bread and wine. No, you go back there, you have coffee and donuts like it's a fucking substitute.
Dude,
Dude, my church served bacon.
What are you just describing?
You know, in Bible study at my church, you get bacon and eggs and pancakes and muffins and all kinds of good shit.
Can I go to your church?
I don't know what kind of shitty church you're going to, but no wonder you don't like it.
Can I go to your church? Like, possibly go to a Walmart, one of the super churches, you know? You don't have to worry about fucking food.
I
want
to go to IG's church. Because your church has donuts and shit.
It's got pancakes and eggs and all kinds of yummy shit in the morning. You gotta go to the Bible study, though.
I don't give a fuck. I want some pancakes and eggs, man.
Dude, we'll sing some songs and eat some fucking pancakes. It'll be fucking great. We'll hook up, dude.
Holy fuck. I wanna go to the church, man. I'm gonna divert for some pancakes and eggs. We got, like, all sorts of good shit here.
Yeah. Our church is fun, and there's some hot single ladies there too, man.
See, I was about to go there. I was going to say, do they have some fine ass bitches?
Oh, we got strippers, pole dancers, and right before Bible study. Why don't you come and join us? Yeah, you get a lot of people there.
There's all kinds of hot girls there, dude.
Oh god.
The stupidest video of all time was when. What's her name? I don't even remember her fucking name. Doc versus Religion took a page out of the Bible and rolled a joint. That was the stupidest video of all time.
You know Aldous Valor did that 6 months earlier, right?
So I can't complain.
Aldous Valor did that 6 months earlier and nobody said shit.
I know.
That's because nobody can watch his videos and not laugh at his bug eyes.
I've actually done that in joint. I've actually taken part in a joint that was rolled up in a Bible page.
What?
Amen, I guess.
Did you at least get some of the red letters in there?
That's just a waste of weed, dude.
God forgave me for that.
Were you talking about smoking the Bible?
A good joint paper does.
Wasn't good weed anyway.
Well, even more of a sin, dude.
What I got right now is really good. Last of the Jacksonville Crippy. I actually got it in nickel bags.
What is your wife or prospective wife going to say about your habit?
It's not a habit, because for one thing, I don't know anybody out there to get it from, and I really don't care to have it. This was actually a gift, a going away gift. And I'm probably going to finish it, I'm going to have to finish it before I go on Saturday afternoon.
Mm-hmm. So you're going this Saturday?
Yep.
You know, if you could share a little bit with...
She's supposed to be here in about an hour.
Yeah, man, you could share a little bit with her, and then you wouldn't have to worry about locking up the knives tonight.
As soon as she gives me the word that they're coming into Jacksonville, I gotta start tearing down my computer and packing it up.
What?
Wow.
Holy, you're gonna live in her house? Oh, man, I'm worried.
Also, that way I'll be able to afford, you know, getting my guitar gear again. And if everything goes according to plan tomorrow about a certain situation, I'll be able to go ahead and purchase that when I move, instead of having to wait till next month.
Nice. All bullshit aside, when you can do the music videos that you said you were always doing.
You gotta shut the fuck up.
Hey, you're never gonna do it, are you?
Nobody cares what you have to say, Brett. I don't know why you're in this call.
Perhaps you don't feel you have the talent, I understand.
That made me butt pucker a bit.
You don't have the talent to fucking think or say anything logical, so shut the fuck up.
You've been dabbling on for 3 months. I'll do some music videos. I quit being a whiny bitch.
You've been dabbling on. Lying piece of shit. So shut
I
want
to taste some rock and roll, not this whiny dude in a Dollar General Halloween mask.
Fuck your opinion is. So shut the fuck up. Don't worry about it. Fucking internet.
that stalker?
It don't take much to get in going, does it?
Oh man, I got accused one time of taking advantage of Stigmadeign's easily angered situation by a certain someone.
So, Christian, where the fuck is Strumbotics?
It's the project I'm in.
Yeah, where the fuck is it?
What do you mean, where is it?
Why don't I have a fucking Inventor Gorilla fucking Strumbotics music the fuck video?
What do you mean? What are you talking about?
Where's the fucking music?
The music? It's at the studio on the hard drive. We're working.
When do we get to hear it?
Probably fall.
Rock and roll, Mr.
So, would you say probably fall, I'm going to add the obligatory 3 fucking months to it and say, by Christmas, it's okay for me to nag you about this fucking shit again. Because where the fuck is the fucking product?
Dude, we're having some drummer issues right now. We're being picky.
God, you sound like every fucking band I've ever heard of.
Well, no, see, we have drummers, it's just I'm being picky about who plays what. We have 2 drummers, and so they both play drummers and they both play keys, so they're both writing drums and keys, and so we're working out there's a lot of shit to do, man. Give me a fucking break. The music's gonna be fucking...
Why don't you get you a drum machine or something, man? A lot of bands on the industrial thing.
Because there's nothing like, you know, having a real percussionist. You know what I'm saying? No.
Why don't you have Stigmadeign?
What you're saying, you have to sit here and go through all this bullshit, though, for a drummer.
That's part of coming up with good music is getting other people to work with you. Doing it all yourself makes it always kind of one or just two-dimensional. But the more members you get and the more you can work together and collaborate, the more dimension you give the music. And I'm sorry if I don't want to just throw out some you know, two-dimensional stuff.
Yeah, and have to explain every little detail that sounds a little odd to everybody. I hate that, too. You know, giving somebody an unfinished product, you know, is a bunch of bullshit.
I don't think it's odd at all. I completely understand why you're waiting. You know, you can put some rest.
So, if you're gonna, like, rip off Slipknot, why not just have Stigmadeign mail you that fucking wolf mask?
Oh, that's rough.
Because we're not ripping off Slipknot.
Really? You got 2 fucking drummers and you're, like, adding as many fucking musicians as possible. That's fucking Slipknot.
No, it's not. There's
watch you fucking be Screamo, too.
No, it's not fucking dude.
Screamo and then Emo.
You're going to overgeneralize my project because we have 2 drummers compared to Slipknot. When how many bands have had 2 drummers? I mean, there's been at least a dozen.
Well, no, it's...
Probably more than a dozen.
Hell, James Brown had 2 drummers.
You know, so... And it's not like we're ripping anybody off. As a matter of fact, the genre is really different. And it's another reason why we're having a little bit of difficulties, because we're not just falling into what we've envisioned, you know? So, we're taking our time with it, and I'm not trying to rush it. A crossover between dubstep and metal. And a couple of the bands that are like this, it's complicated, but this fall, we'll have...
You're breaking up.
Dubstep and metal and something in the fall.
Yeah.
Hope he gets that going.
Christian?
Yeah?
$10 bet over PayPal right now. When your shit comes out, I will put up a poll on my fucking channel. I will say, hey everybody, listen to this. And tell me if it sounds like Screamo Emo.
Well, you can't pay the bet now.
No, I'm saying when it comes out,
my
viewers will call it Screamo Emo.
No, they won't, because my vocalist isn't a Screamo.
I'll just do it to be on his side. So he's already got one vote.
I hear you saying no, but I see where it's going. I have this feeling, this horrible feeling.
All right, I can't. I'm now curious.
Well, you know, your horrible feeling is exactly why we're taking so much time. Because so you're extremely picky. What?
He must be lagging like a son of a bitch. Are you in, what kind of locals are you into?
Well, personally, do really, 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 really heavy music. So.
Yeah, but sometimes heavy kid rock type of. So I've got James Hetfield Slayer type of voice. What kind of voice you going with?
I like the I like the James Hetfield, with a little bit of Phil Anselmo from Pantera. And lately I've been listening to Volbeat, which is a really different vocal style for me. It's called Elvis metal. The guy sings with a southern draw.
We already got a band like that. They're called Danzig.
No, dude. If you heard Volbeat, it's different.
There's also the Cult.
And Dan,
listen to him. He's one of the most negative motherfuckers on this planet. He's gonna shoot down somebody's fucking hopes at every little turn.
Well, there's already a band called Danzig.
Yeah.
Man, fucking shut up, Brett.
Actually, bitch boy, I like Danzig.
Good for fucking you. Go suck his dick, man. Nobody cares.
Go brush your tooth, right? You fucking mutt.
I know I'm a mutt. At least I know where I come from and not no fucking whore parent.
This guy is wonderful.
Now, are you a Christian?
Supposed to be.
Not during this show.
Wait, you can put that shit aside for a little bit? What the fuck is that shit? You can...
Get it off, right?
Being sarcastic.
See, that, at least Inventor's consistent. I like consistency. You stayed in my...
consistently fucking boring, right, dude?
Passing it, bullying him off of YouTube. Yeah, you really like consistency.
That one minute is, I love Jesus, the next minute, I'm going to shoot me in the...
Shut up, man. Shut the fuck up. All this bullshit, fucking... Every fucking time you open your mouth, bullshit.
This is very funny.
I know. That's a
great... Hilarious.
So, you guys think we should do this again sometime? We're all breaking up, huh?
I feel better. I feel like everyone got to brush it out.
Mm-hmm.
We are. It's all talk at the same time. Yeah. All
right. Well, next time I have a BlogTV, if I see all you motherfuckers in my next BlogTV, I'm just gonna pull you all in again, and we can all fucking scream at each other again.
No, we're on BlogTV.
Oh yeah, motherfucker.
Oh, I did not know that. Okay.
Surprise.
Well.
Broadcast for everyone to fucking hear.
First place recorded in the slaughter.
All 10 of them. All 10 of us. Really is
okay.
Don't sell me short. I had 12 at the peak.
When you plan to do another BlogTV there, man?
I normally do one every Wednesday, but it normally doesn't devolve into this lovely fest.
Him. Oh, shut the hell up, you fucking high-ass, fucking fake-ass bitch.
Fucking high.
That fucking
feisty. Fucking loud-ass fucking drawling fucking
puked bastard mouth.
Bring a little salsa into the situation.
If you can get Don Keen to swear like that, you've done wrong, my friend.
That's good stuff. I now have an erection. Thank you, Don.
You're welcome.
That's a good note to end on. I do these every Wednesday, but normally I have something in politics that I talk about. It doesn't normally devolve into this, but I'm sure this is more interesting than what I normally do. So
I'll be down for next Wednesday. I'll actually know what's going on next time.
Wednesdays are my night.
Cool.
Sounds good.
All right.
Have a good evening.
Evening, everyone.
Ta-ta.
Go to hell.